الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، بيده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين. نحمده أن أكملنا ديننا وأتم علينا نعمته ورضي الإسلام دينا. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة، هو الرحمن الرحيم سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وقائدنا ومعلمنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، نشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده وعبد ربه حتى أتاه اليقين منه. فاللهم صل عليه وارض اللهم عن زوجاته وآله وصحابته والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، I bear witness that there is no God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of universe, who created me and you and all humans, who created us for one purpose, to worship him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last messenger to humans. I bear witness that he completed the deen. I bear witness that he struggled for this deen. I bear witness that he brought mercy and happiness and joy to humans. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Dear brothers, respected sisters, this is the month of Rajab, one of the months where the Ummah goes back to the history to read about this month, what happened in this month, and why we remember this month. This is the month where the Muslims, they learn again and again about being patient, setting the goals, reminding themselves first, then reminding the humanity that we are here in this life to build harmony and peace and worship Almighty God, and nothing else. This is the month where our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went through journey to Jerusalem first, then from Jerusalem to the unseen universe, عالم الغيب, إلى الملأ الأعلى, to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to pray 5 times a day. Agreed with him that this is mandatory prayers which should be implemented in the earth 5 times a day. And you know, before that Allah asked him 50 times. Then because of Musa alayhi salam, Moses, peace be upon him, he told him, your nation will not be able to accomplish this. Go back, return to your Lord, and ask him to lower it more. And then he went back and forth, and you know the story. But today, as American Muslims, we need to go back to that story. We need to read it, understand it, but read between lines. This is the time of our struggle, yes. This is the time where some people there, out there, they are pointing on us. There is a time where our sisters, they are scared walking in the street because of their hijab. This is the time when it comes the Asr prayer or Dhuhr praying. You know, before I go to anywhere to pray, I have to look around. Is there anybody there? Because we are scared. Something is going on within ourselves. Something is holding us. It's fear. It's normal. Nothing bad about it. It's human. But what is not normal, when that fear comes between you and living your regular life. What is not normal is when you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who managed the universe, is the one who owns everything, is the one who says, as he said about himself in the Quran, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Be and it be. This is where the problem. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to live in Mecca. He started his da'wah, calling people to the right path, telling them, you know what? Leave what you believe in. Those idols, they cannot do anything for you or against you. Leave them aside. I want to free you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam struggled to fight against slavery. He wanted to free humans from a human being to worship the one who created the human being. He struggled for 13 years in Mecca. The 10th year in Mecca, he lost his allies, his wife. She used to be a businesswoman, taking care of him, taking care of his project, because she believed in him. He told her, this is our project for life. This is our mission. And she put the money down on the table. She said, you know what? Here is my money. Here is my business for you. Go. Run with it. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it. Then Abu Talib radiallahu, Abu Talib, his uncle, he told him, you know what? I will not leave you alone. I am with you, even if I don't believe in your Lord. Allies. The 10th year of Al-Bi'ta, everything is gone. It's like today. Then he needs to support himself. He needs to do whatever it takes to deliver that message of good, that message of mercy to others. He left Mecca, where he struggled. He went to a Ta'if. And you know this story about the Ta'if. No one wants to believe in him. The kids, they threw the stones on him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His foot was bleeding. At that time, at that moment where nobody wants to hear him, he stood nearby a garden. Then someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, moved some mercy inside him. You know, he approached him, he said, here is some grapes for you, because I see you that you are a stranger. At that moment when he was alone and nobody was with him except Zayd radiallahu anhu ardah, his servants, he told him, you know what? Here is something for you to eat. And then he told him, where are you from? He said, I am from Nineveh, Al-Iraq. He said, oh, Nineveh is the country of my brother, Yunus alayhi salam. Then they start chatting. Later, that man became a Muslim. He believed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What does it mean for us today, brothers and sisters? We are not in that struggle yet. We are not at that moment. We are struggling, yes. There is some struggle there. We are not okay. We can say it. But we are not at that level of struggle that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be in. Let me ask you this question. How many neighbors did we want to and introduce ourselves to them? How many churches did we knock the door, say, you know what, my name is Muhammad, I want just to introduce myself, let us build the capacity of our institutions to fight against violence, against drug, against all those diseases, social diseases that we have today. How many of us did this? How many of us took that message from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and delivered it to others? I'm asking this question because myself, I know there's a lot of shortcomings with my work. With my work within myself and with the community. I know this for sure. I'm not going to hide it. But this is for us, it's a signal. Rajab is the month of signals. Rajab is the month of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. And that Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj should be for us a light inside that tunnel, which is very dark tunnel. And we need to learn from it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam coming back to Mecca. Imagine, coming back to somewhere nobody wants to hear you. They hate you. Huh? There are posters everywhere, as they said, wanted. You go to Mecca, what will happen to you? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he didn't forget about him. He told him, you know what? And this is the lesson, brothers and sisters. I want you to hear this. If the whole world, if the universe is going against you, now that there is somebody who will take care of you. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that night took him from Mecca to Jerusalem. Then from Jerusalem to Al-Mala Al-A'la to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to meet all the prophets. Peace be upon them. For us, this represents a glimpse of hope. There is hope there. If we sit and think about it as humans, we'll say, you know what? This da'wah, this message will go nowhere. Because there is no support. Nobody is there. He's alone. But when you think about it today, 1.6 billion Muslims, where they come from? Who manages this? Who took care of it? That man, which is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was alone. At that moment, he was alone. His companions, some riwayat, the recitation, they said 35. Some of them, they say 40. Some of them, they say 60. Anyway, no more than 100. Let's see 100 sahabi at that time. But most of them, they were struggling at the time. They cannot even go outside, say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They have to wait until Umar radiallahu anhu become Muslim, and then he went outside, say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, in front of Meccans. The reality is a struggle reality. But those 100 that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam invest on them. This is what we called a human building capacity. We have to build our capacities, brothers and sisters. We have to build ourselves first. We have to build that belief, that our belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has to become very strong belief before we do anything. We have to recognize that this religion, this message, is the message of all humans. It's not just a message for Muslims. It addresses all the issues that we are living with today. There is an answer there. Starting with the social justice, brothers and sisters, that we are missing today. There is a gap in the society. But who is going to close it, to close that gap? Getting closer and closer. Who? If not me and you and other allies outside there. Churches and temples, those who believe in humanity. We have to do our part, brothers and sisters. Because we cannot say, you know what, I am Muslim, I came to the masjid, I pray and I leave, that's it, it's done. It's not done, brothers and sisters. It's 24 hours a day. 7 days a week. 365 days a year. Because we are responsible. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَا يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلَوْمًا جَهُولًا. This is a trade with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting on our shoulder. What happened outside the masjid is in my shoulder and your shoulder, brothers and sisters. Anything happened to humans, we should look at it as humans, but we should look at it with the heart full of mercy and nothing else. I am saying this because our ummah is going through a lot of struggle today. You have wars everywhere. Look at what happened in Syria right now. Look at what happened in Yemen. Look at what happened in Libya. They're going through a lot of famine. Starving. We have 26 million people are starving today in East Africa. Who is going to take care of them? If we don't give them anything, if we don't support them, maybe by end of June or July, there are statistics which says, you know what studies which says, you know what, half of them will be gone, which is 13 million. Whose work is this? Nobody else except us. Because they are humans. Forget about they are Muslims. They are humans. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in authentic hadith, مَنْ لَمْ يَهْتَمَّ بِأُمُرُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَلَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ. And another hadith said, and this is very tough hadith, when Rasulullah sallam said, if you know, if you are going to sleep with full stomach and you know that your neighbor doesn't have anything to eat and the kids and the wife are sleeping with no food, لَقَدْ بَرِئَتْ مِنْكَ ذِمَّةُ اللَّهِ. You are out of the Muslim society. You are not believing in Muhammad anymore. You are believing in something else. And why I'm saying this, brothers and sisters? Because we have to go back to this teaching. There are teachings that we forget about every day, but we need to go back to them because the society is waiting for us. Outside society is waiting for you and me to give them some good. And we must do it. Be Christian, Jewish, whatever you want to be. Who cares about it when it comes to see the life of people in struggle? When you see those people are struggling every day, when you see brothers and sisters who do not have anything to give to their kids to eat, it's a piece of bread and water they need, nothing else. They're not asking about nice suit or nice shoes. Forget about shoes. They are asking about food and water. That's it. Who will be asked in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? For sure, 100%. Because وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you want to count the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us, you cannot complete it. There are a lot of bounties, and one of them is this gathering today. This is a bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we come here to gather today to discuss the issues of our society at large, to discuss the issue of our hearts, how we can enlighten that heart, how we can turn on the light in that heart, how can we link that heart to Almighty God subhanahu wa ta'ala, how can we come back to the human values, because we lost those human values. What happened in the world right now? Because of lack of human values. Because no one with the, what they call it, healthy mind, will shoot anybody. Then why there is shooting everywhere? Why there is all these diseases everywhere? Because the mind is sick and the heart is dark. There is no light. Once the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inside, the life will change. Once we change ourselves, the surrounding us will change. Then the circle become a bigger circle. Then we will live in harmony and then we'll live in peace. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم استغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله المصطفى الأمين صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. Dear brothers, respected sisters, as I mentioned, we have and we carry responsibility in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I came today, most of you know me, I give khutbah al-jumu'ah here often, and then I am one of the community members here. But I came today on behalf of those 26 million. I repeat, 26 million who do not have access to water. I have this bottle here. For them, this is gold. They don't have access to a piece of bread. Wallahi, I was among them there. I sit there for a week. I know what's going on there. Brothers and sisters, this is test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. لِيَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. I came today on their behalf, on behalf of Islamic Relief, to ask your support. Ask you, please, don't turn your back to them. Please don't. If we don't take care of them, nobody else will do. It's our responsibility as humans, and it's our duty as Muslims. You say, you know what, $5 is nothing? No, $5 is something. $10 is something. 25 cents is something. Because believe me, wallahi الذي لا إله غيره. I went to some areas. When you ask the mother, how is life? She tells you exactly this. Brother, when I wake up in the morning, I don't know what to give to my kids because I don't have anything to eat. I have to wait for somebody to bring them food. These are, I went to the camp, 286,000 refugees are there waiting for somebody to give them what to eat. There's nothing there. And this is why I'm here today. I don't want to take much of your time. After Salah, please bear with me 2 minutes because I need to do fundraising. And I am doing the fundraising because I am not doing for somebody else. I'm doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to show Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I did. My share is there. My responsibility, I take it from my shoulder to the Muslim community and to the ones who hear it today. It's up on us right now. Whatever you want to do. I will have a table outside, inshallah, Ahmar Rahim. There is pledges there. I will do fundraising for 2 minutes. And after fundraising, there is Salat al-Janaza, inshallah, Ahmar Rahim. There is a brother, I think, his name is Brother Arif Kidwa. He is 90 years old from India. He passed away. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on him. We have Janaza, inshallah, Ahmar Rahim, after the fundraising. Please bear with us. Allahumma aghfir lana dunubana, kabiraha wa saghiraha, azimaha wa haqiraha. اللهم توفنا مسلمين اللهم توفنا وانت راضي عنا يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين اللهم احفظ هذا البلد وسائر بلد المسلمين اللهم احفظ هذا البلد وسائر بلد المسلمين اللهم احفظ هذا البلد وسائر بلد المسلمين اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما اخرنا وما اسررنا وما اعلنا وما انت اعلم منا انت المقدم وانت المؤخر لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا من الظالمين اللهم تب علينا توبة نصوحة اللهم ارحم موتى المسلمين اللهم ارحم موتى المسلمين اللهم ارحم والدينا كما ربونا صغارا اللهم اجزهم باحسان احسانا وبالسيئات عفوا ومغفرة يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الرياء يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين اللهم احفظ مؤسسات المسلمين من عبث العابثين وخداع المخادعين يا اكرم الاكرمين يا رب العالمين عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون واقم الصلاه